you had to go and drive me so crazy. Now I'm feeling lost without you, and I just can't be.
Okay, well, I was gonna wear this, you know, like give you all the fall vibes here, but I was just dancing my little behind off, and it is way too warm in here to wear this now, so. Hello, beautiful souls. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome to my channel if you are new here. My name is Kristen Martin. I am a light worker, a best-selling author, a creative entrepreneur, a content creator. I like to do all the things. So, for today's video, I was reviewing a lot of my old videos, you know, just kind of like going down memory lane a little bit. And I noticed that I have a lot of videos on writing fiction, how to write fiction, and all of the different components of your story. But I've made no videos on writing nonfiction, and specifically because the nonfiction that I have written is more in the self-help, personal growth, personal development, however you want to categorize it, space, I was like, huh, maybe I should do a video on how to write a personal development book. Real quick, I just wanted to give a shout out to all of you who have been with me for some time, maybe since the very beginning of my author journey, or you know, this whole journey here on YouTube, because I am about to hit 2 million views on my channel, which is just crazy. Like, that's so insane to me. And I just looked at That Smart Hustle podcast to see how many unique downloads there were, and I started That Smart Hustle in 2017. I think it was like July 2017 timeframe, and I have almost hit 500,000 unique downloads on that podcast. So I just want to say thank you guys so much for showing up, for listening to the content, for watching the videos. I appreciate that more than I can possibly tell you. And that's why I'm just like, this is so crazy that I'm sitting here and I'm about to share some secrets and some advice when it comes to writing, personal development, and self-help. Because honestly, I never really knew that that was a genre that I was going to get into. Before we jump into these 7 secrets, I did want to let you know that my self-study coaching program for writers called Valiance is open for enrollment, but it is only open for enrollment for 2 more weeks. So that will be closing on September 30th. If you are an aspiring author and you want a roadmap that is completely laid out for you when it comes to brainstorming your story, outlining it, writing it, editing it, publishing it, marketing it, all, you know, the entire process, the entire book creation process, then I highly encourage you to check out that program. You can find the link in the description box below. Along the same lines, I also wanted to give you a heads up that my self-study course, Write 50K in 30 Days, which used to be called Conquering NaNoWriMo, it went through a rebranding, is available to sign up if that's something that you are interested in. If Valiance, if that's like, you know, a huge investment right now, or it's something that you're like, I really want to do that, but I need to kind of like dip my toe in the water first, then that course, Write 50K in 30 Days, is a great stepping stone. And since NaNoWriMo is just around the corner, I am running a sale through September 30th on Write 50K in 30 Days. So it is a $200 value, but through September 30th, you can get it for just $97. It comes with a 35-page editable, downloadable workbook, as well as 4 weekly pep talk videos on topics like procrastination and overcoming writer's block and staying in flow. And there's also 2 additional trainings on outlining your novel, which is like a 20-minute workshop, and a video on how to self-edit your novel and what my updated process looks like. So you can learn more about that course and sign up by clicking on the link in the description box below. Okay, let's get into my 7 secrets for writing a must-read self-help book. Number 1 is to determine your focus area. And I know that might sound kind of confusing. You're probably thinking, I'm writing self-help and personal development, so that is the focus area. But actually, if you go onto Amazon and look at self-help and look at all the different categories, you will see that there are so many more like subcategories, sub-genres. So it's really important to pick your focus area and understand what it is you want to write about specifically. So to give you an example of some of these subcategories on Amazon, they include things like personal transformation, self-esteem, spiritual, motivational, relationship, stress management, and anxieties and phobias. As you can see, there are so many subcategories, so really zoning in on which one you want to be your focus area for your self-help book is step number one. Number two is to brainstorm keywords that relate to that focus topic. And this is how I map out all of my personal development books. For instance, if you want to write a personal development book that is focused on relationships, some key words that you might think of when it comes to relationships are loyalty, reciprocation, love, spouse, partner, family, friends, trust. So when I was writing SoulFlow, I knew that it was gonna be more on the spiritual enlightenment, spiritual transformation, more focused in that subcategory. So the keywords that I brainstormed were things like flow, love, resistance, fear, shame, guilt, awakening, light. These were all keywords that came to me. And if you have read SoulFlow, then you will see that a lot of those words I just mentioned are main chapter headings, like they're the main chapters in that book. So when you brainstorm keywords that are associated with that subcategory, with that subgenre, you'll have a much easier time outlining the actual chapter content. Number three is to gather as many personal stories as you can for each of these keywords. So to use SoulFlow as an example again, when I looked at the keyword awakening, the first thing I thought of, a story that went along with my spiritual awakening, was when I was in Bali. When I looked at the keyword flow, I immediately thought of flow versus hustle when it came to working in a corporate job versus being a full-time creative entrepreneur. So the more personal stories that you can gather for each one of those keywords, the easier it's going to be when you're actually writing the chapters, because that's a lot of what self-help and personal development is taking a situation, a circumstance, something that you've experienced and sharing what you've learned from it and how you got through it. So that leads us to number four, which is to then reflect on those personal stories and identify applicable takeaways. A great way to do this is to have a section for reflection or journal prompts at the end of each one of your chapters that asks specific questions to allow the reader to reflect on everything they've just read and apply it to their personal life and their situation. My fifth secret when it comes to writing a must-read self-help book is to only write one chapter per writing session. Unlike fiction, when you're writing nonfiction, and specifically when you are writing self-help, I found that when I would write two chapters in one writing session, or if that was something I was trying to do, my voice would almost sound too similar, or the stories, like the voice of the story that I was telling would kind of carry over. And you might think that that's something that you would want, but it got to a point where it was starting to sound too similar. So for example, you might be trying to get a point across or tell a story and have, you know, your applicable takeaway that you're getting across in one chapter. And then as you go to write the second chapter, you find that you're almost being redundant or you're repeating yourself a little bit because you were focused on the chapter before, and that's all carrying over into the next chapter, if that makes sense. I have found that the best way to write each chapter is fresh eyes, fresh chapter. You could almost think of them as like individual articles or individual blog posts, like you're writing each one individually. So each time you sit down, it should be like a fresh slate, a clean slate. Number six is to identify how you want the reader to feel after they are done reading that chapter. You also want to identify what action you hope the reader will take. So when I look at my two personal development books, I have Be Your Own Hashtag Goals and I have SoulFlow. Be Your Own Hashtag Goals was more like motivation, fired up, like I am Wonder Woman, I am ready to take on the world. It was like the kick in the pants that you need to go out and like attack your goals and your dreams and like just go after it. SoulFlow, on the other hand, was a little bit more of an intimate book for me to write. It was based more on like the internal and soul healing, like that soul level healing, transformation, reflection. So really getting in tune with your higher self. It was a much more spiritual book than Be Your Own Hashtag Goals was. So knowing what actions you want the reader to take at the end of the book and how they should feel is crucial. And lastly, secret number seven, vulnerability is your superpower. If you're going to share your stories, your experiences, the things that have happened to you, how you've gotten through it, you have to share all of it. There is no like sharing half of something or going in halfway. Like you have to go all in when you're writing a personal development book. The thing about self-help, the thing about personal development is that underlying knowing of the fact that we all struggle as human beings. We all have our struggles. We all have challenges and things that we're facing on a daily basis. The point of self-help is to read about another person's struggle and learn how they got through it. The facade of perfect does not work when it comes to writing self-help. So if you're gonna sit there and pretend like everything's okay, it's all like sunshine and daisies and roses, then I would maybe encourage you to think a little bit more if self-help or personal development is really the genre that you want to be writing. Because again, the reason that people read self-help and personal development is to get that motivation, to get that inspiration, to learn about the way that other people have struggled in the hopes that they can find some similarity or resonance with that other person's struggle that they can then absorb and, you know, find some key takeaways that they can apply to their own situation. So that is it for today's video. Those are my 7 secrets when it comes to writing a must-read self-help book. If you enjoyed today's video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up to support my channel, and don't forget to click that subscribe button as well as that little bell. That will send you email notifications to your inbox whenever I upload new videos. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate you more than you know, and I will see you in next week's video. With love and light.